Everyone, it's Carolyn Strnad, Family Resource Coordinator with the Minnesota Organization on Fetal Alcohol Syndrome. I hope you're doing well today. I am going to be talking about that accommodations and modification page in the IEP. For those of you who are familiar with the Individual Education Plan or IEP, do you know what the most important page of that document is? A gold star for all those who guessed the Supplemental AIDS page, or more commonly referred to as the adaptations page. So why is that section of the IEP so critical? Certainly the goals drive the areas of need that can be addressed, and the service times is critical to ensuring that those goals are worked on. But the real meat of the IEP is the accommodations and modifications that students receive to assist them in meeting those goals. For our kids with FASD, those accommodations can make a difference in our son or daughter being able to participate in the school's least restrictive environment. First, a terminology refresher. Supplemental aids and services are the accommodations, modifications, assistive technology, and paraprofessional support a student may need. Accommodations are those services, assistance, and materials that a student requires to be independent in the classroom and assist in his or her ability to do the work required. Instructional material is not changed, only how it is learned. Modifications change the level of difficulty or focus of the classwork or test. Supports are the indirect services that the educational staff is provided to ensure your child can participate fully in school. Assistive technology includes devices that can aid in your child's independent participation in school. So let's talk about each area of the Supplemental Aids and Services section separately so that you can get a better idea of what types of things to be considered or requested. Assistive technology can include both devices and service minutes. The devices can be something that the school purchases for your student to use or something they developed based on your son or daughter's needs. Examples of those devices include graphic organizers, handheld computers, software such as word prediction, voice recognition, and text to read. It can also include simple items such as pencil grips, sensory seat cushions, to assist in attending and visual charts. Service minutes for an AT staff working with your child to learn how to use the device need to be listed as direct minutes. It should also list where the student will receive the direct instruction, for example, the regular education setting or in an AT resource room setting. Remembering that our kids do not often generalize skills learned over all environments, it will be critical for the team to determine where that learning on using the AT device will occur. Now, supports are those services provided to the educational staff and not directly to the student. Minutes for this service should be listed on the IEP's service page as indirect minutes. Examples of those support services include consultations such as vision consult or disability coordinator, observations of the child, either AT or behavioral, typically, planning assistance for the team, teaching educational staff or paraprofessionals how to use an assistive technology device, or training personnel to help in training the team on the child's disability. A great place to request that staff working with your child trained on FASD, and do let them know that MOFAS has great training curriculum for teachers. Now, paraprofessionals, as many of you know, is an individual or individuals assigned to the student, or in most cases, shared with one or more student, to provide hands-on support. The responsibilities of the para need to be listed on the adaptations page and include such things as reading tests, ensure that the student has recorded assignments, turned in those assignments, modifying the work as needed, reteaching material, ensuring student understands the directions given, checking work for accuracy, etc. Now, depending on your school district, it may be critical for the success of this service that everyone your child Everything your child needs, the paraprofessional for, is spelled out in the IEP, so there are no questions as to who's responsible for each activity. So the modifications. Now, some ideas of modifications that have worked well for our kids with FASD include directions written at a lower reading level. Our kids may be able to read at a certain grade level, but that doesn't mean they can comprehend at that level. Shortening the spelling list, tests on key concepts, shortening assignments, study guides with page references for ease in finding answers, the ability to receive a pass or fail grade in place of a letter grade, omitting assignments that require copying or dictating to them, such as spelling tests, weigh the daily work higher than tests when grading, completing independent projects in place of a test, etc. There are a wide range of modifications that can be used, and it would be great for the team to really think outside the box to identify those needs for your son or daughter. Accommodations, such as break tests into small steps, give instructions one at a time, visual directions, visual rules and schedules, multi-sensory instructions, summaries of chapters, teacher lecture notes, study guides, highlighted textbooks are some of those that are great for working with our kids with FASD. Also, one set of textbooks for home and one for school eliminates the issue of a child forgetting to bring his books home. A use of study carols can work great for those that are highly distracted and should not be seen as a punishment. Seating students near appropriate role models, a study buddy, additional time to complete work, allow for retaking tests, a use of calculator allowed, and fewer math problems on a sheet are just a few more of those accommodations that can be developed for our kids. For older students, it may work best to cluster classes within the building to assist with transition. For my boys, having resource time at the beginning, middle, and end of the day really made a difference in keeping them organized and on task with work. It's amazing what even 10 minutes can do to help with this challenge that the majority of our kids struggle with. Before I end this video, I want to take some time to talk about accommodations and modifications for the behavioral challenges our kids have. We all know that this is probably the most difficult hurdle to jump over within the school system. Schools want our kids to follow their rules or be given the consequences set out in the district policy manual. Our kids want to follow the rules, but oftentimes they act impulsive, act because a peer encouraged them to do it, and can be easily frustrated with the demands of the schoolwork and the environment and act out that frustration. And consequences given by the educational system do not deter them from breaking the rule again. First and foremost, request the school staff be trained on FASD. If they have some basic understanding of why the brain works the way it does for our kids, they may have more compassion regarding those behavioral challenges and work with the team to come up with a plan that allows the child to be safe, his peers safe, and school staff safe. One piece of advice that I received many years ago when we were struggling with some significant behaviors of our daughter was to have included on the adaptations page that she would follow the school rules, but the team would decide the consequence. In that way, we were teaching her that rules needed to be followed, but the team, who understood her disability, would provide a consequence that would fit the crime, so to speak. Other modifications and accommodations that may be helpful include reward positive behavior, ignore negative behavior when possible, use verbal or nonverbal cues to alert the child when doing inappropriate behavior, provide a get-out-of-class-free card so the student can leave if necessary and go to the resource room or counseling office when frustrated. Increase the frequency of reinforcements is also another good option. When our daughter was in second grade, she received a warm fuzzy, which was a small felt material block, every 2 minutes of positive behavior. It immediately stopped the behavior. was an excellent tool, and we continued to list it on our accommodations page until she outgrew the need for such an immediate reward. For more information on this topic and other topics, please check out our website at www.mofas.org. Thank you.